renowned hypnoscientist and TV's favorite hypnotist, Tom Silver. All right, hi everybody, I'm Tom Silver, and I am a hypnotist, a hypnotherapist, and I'm really glad to be here. It's amazing to be at a NATO convention. I get to tell everyone at home, I went to a NATO convention. Yeah, I've been in the field of scientific hypnosis and hypnosis for 35 years. And I teach courses around the world. I teach neurofeedback, brainwave frequency monitoring. I train and teach a lot of doctors, neurologists, and other medical people the science of hypnosis. You know, as you know, hypnosis really is a science. It's a recognized science. It was actually recognized a few hundred years ago, because back in the late 1700s and early 1800s, everyone practicing hypnotism, back then it was called magnetism or mesmerism, were actually medical doctors in huge hospitals in Europe. So I love the science of hypnosis. I help people change their lives. I work with people with PTSD, obesity, post-traumatic stress disorder, fears, phobias, panic attacks, and addiction. Now, for a long time, I've been on a lot of TV shows, so that's why I kind of call myself TV's favorite hypnotist. It's a little corny, but it works. I started off in 1998 with my first CBS television special called Hypnotized. Now, I hypnotized the ex-president of ABC television, Ted Harbert, in front of Les Moonves, who was the president of CBS. And I did some fun stuff, creative stuff. I turned them into Frank Sinatra singing a song, and Bill Clinton talking about some events that occurred back then. But anyway, it sold the show. I won't get into those events. But it was a street reality comedy show. And a lot of people get a little confused, because hypnosis is an art, and it is also an amazing science. And it's being used in hospitals more than ever before. Other shows I've been on, The Doctors, removing nicotine addiction. The other half with Dick Clark and Danny Bonaducci and Mario Lopez. And it was great working with Dick Clark. Beyond with James Van Praagh, who was a psychic. Fox Special Powers of the Paranormal. Jeff Probst's show, The Home and Family Show. And this reminded me during your beginning of the presentation. When I was a younger guy and I actually had hair on my head and I looked a little bit different, I hypnotized an actor on The Home and Family Show. Back then, Chuck Woolery and Christina Ferrari were the hosts of that show. I think it was on Fox Family Network. Anyway, I hypnotized him to help him play better golf, because he had a mental block. And then a few years back, since I was the NBA halftime show hypnotist for about 14 years, Charles Barkley called me. You know, he had just left the Houston Rockets, real nice gentleman. He came over to see me to help him with he has like a swing block, and I did my darndest, but I wasn't able to help him. I failed. But it was still very interesting, and it was pretty neat. So I've had a chance to do a lot of things over the years. I write books on hypnosis. This is how I used to look in the old days. My old press photo. When I was the young, up-and-coming hypnotist. Anyway, I'm here to talk about Murder's Trance, because it's a fantastic movie. It's a movie based on a real life story that actually occurred in Copenhagen. It involved two imprisoned Nazis, and one of them actually hypnotized the other one, programmed him through certain hypnotic suggestions, persuasive techniques, programmed him to be able to commit crimes, to be kind of like what we might call also a pathological killer. And the movie is just really fantastic because it's based on a true life story. They got caught and went to the courts, went throughout all the courts in Copenhagen. It was the biggest crime in Denmark history. And the verdict at the end was that the perpetrator, Bjorn Nelson, the instigator, programmed Hardra to commit the crime. So one got sent to a mental hospital, and they got released in 1967. The other one went into prison, one of the toughest prisons in Denmark, and he was there until 1967 when they were both released. After that, the law enforcement, there was a gentleman named Olsen, who was a detective that worked on the case, and so they kept investigating the guy. He kept on manipulating people. and committing crimes. And finally, in 1967, he became a full-blown alcoholic and he committed suicide. Now, what's interesting is Arto Holliman is the movie producer. He wrote the screenplay. He's also a hypnotherapist, a hypnotist trained in hypnotism. An amazing gentleman. He was the director and the producer of this film. He actually met the gentleman, Hardrup, who was programmed. Arto met him in 1997 and was so interested in this crime, in this case, in this true life story, that he became obsessed in it. And he worked with the gentleman that committed the crimes, Hardrup, for a number of years. Hardrup died in 2012. But it's such a fascinating movie because it's based on putting in what we call a hypnotic seal or a hypnotic lock, meaning the gentleman that programmed the murderer put in a code, and if you didn't know the code, you couldn't crack him. You couldn't get him back into hypnosis to remove that code. So it's really an amazing story. It's fascinating. A lot of twists and turns in murderous trance. And when Arto called me, he called me because of my work in Taiwan with the Defense Department. So I get a call from Arto Holliman about 6 months ago. He was doing a screening in Santa Barbara. He thought I still lived in California, but my wife and I, we moved to Medford, Oregon. So he called me to invite me to screening, and he did some research and found out that I worked on the biggest murder and weapon scandal in Taiwan and French history. And it was a scandal that involved $2.4 billion, the murder of Captain Yin, a weapons procurement officer, and the misappropriation and embezzlement of money laundered in South Africa and Switzerland, and the purchase of defective battleships from France. And this went all the way up to the presidencies of Mitterrand and President Lee of Taiwan. So the Department of Defense asked me to help them to hypnotize people of interest and imprison military procurement officers to get the truth out of them. I was told it couldn't be done, but you know, hey, I'm an experimenter, I'm a scientist, and I get an opportunity to try something maybe that's never been done before. And all I have to do is figure out how to crack a code. I'm kind of like a code cracker. Not a safe cracker, but a code cracker. So anyway, I worked on these guys, these imprisoned procurement officers, and I did a little bit of covert hypnosis. I won't get into how I set it up. But once I got them under, and once I did a regression and took them back to the event, I brought in the Department of Defense, the Secret Service, head of police, head of the military, head of technology, to ask non-leading questions to the perpetrators, the imprisoned officers, under hypnosis for about 8 to 10 hours at a time. And then I just simply blocked the memory when they came out, so they basically thought they fell asleep. You know, and it's really interesting because so many people don't understand hypnosis. They don't think it's real. I've been called a magician, mandrake, and you're like a psychic or an illusionist. No, I'm a mind technologist. And every one of you have actually been hypnotized. We all go into these altered brainwave states every single day. We go into states of focused concentration and memory cognitive distraction, amnestic amnesia states. Let me give you an example. You watch a movie. You're all movie people, and hopefully you'll see the benefit of running a movie like this, because it gets people to think about our minds, because we are being programmed. A lot of people are being programmed every day through certain repetitions and things in the media. But you go to a movie theater, you watch the movie goes on, you're aware of everything around you, you know, the people next to you, everything. All of a sudden you start to focus in the movie, and all of a sudden you're involved in the movie. I like to say, all of a sudden, when I watch a movie, I become the movie. I live the movie. Now, you don't see me on the screen. I'm like the guy on the side. But I am so involved emotionally, visually, feeling kinesthetically, that I am in an entranced state. So you can actually say really fantastic movies take you into this roller coaster of emotions, and they put you into this hypnotized type of state. So everyone who feels the emotions of a movie goes into hypnosis. A sad movie, you feel sad, you cry. Exciting movie, you're on the edge of your seat. A comedy, you're laughing. You forget that they're actors with scripts, with lines, because it becomes a reality at that point. And you become hypnotized. That's what's so fantastic about the movies. You get to escape from your daily life, and you get to be in this amazing world of reality like murder, trance, or fantasy. And other times we go into hypnosis, driving your car and daydreaming. Any of you ever driven your car and all of a sudden you reach your destination and you wonder, how did I get here, or did I stop at that stoplight? Raise your hands if that's ever happened. Automatic pilot, raise your hands. Happens to most people. Well, who's doing the driving for you? It's your subconscious mind. You know, we only use about 10% of our intellectual, cognitive, reasoning, thought, logical mind. But the emotional part of our mind is where those software programs have been downloaded, like driving on automatic pilot. But yet, under automatic pilot, we have these response, reflex responses. So if the light turns red, we stop. But we're not thinking, I have to stop. But it's already been built into us. Other times, anyone into sports, sports, football, baseball, yeah, basketball? You ever see someone yelling at an athlete on a TV set during a game? Yeah, emotionally involved, you know? But they're in that heightened state of suggestibility. So look at hypnosis as a form of suggestibility. Used correctly, the art of suggestion is powerful. If every day I give myself these auto-suggestions of being happy, that life's wonderful, that I can succeed in everything that I attempt to accomplish, then I become successful. But how many of us use our thinking, intellectual mind, incorrectly? We wake up in the morning, oh God, do I have to get out of bed? I don't want to go to work. And all of that auto-suggestive negative programming we sometimes give ourselves or we accept through the environment. And what's so amazing about this movie is think about what's going on in our world today. I've been recently doing a lot of talk shows. Who's to say that some of these horrible, simply horrible, barbaric crimes that have been occurring, who's to say that some of these people have not been manipulated in one way or another, believing what they're doing is the right thing? So I think it's really important in our current life situation that we realize manipulation of suggestion is all around us. And we don't have to accept everything as the truth. And, you know, and I love politics, I love the news, but guess what? All news isn't fake news. There's great news also, real news, truthful news out there. So I think it's important that we understand that we are exposed to stimulus all the time. And do we let it affect us? Or do we realize that we don't have to be suggestible except to things that are positive? The other thing about murderous trance, which is really interesting, in 1961, they were found guilty, they went to prison, and even the Human Rights, International Human Rights Commission in 1961, they even stated that this crime was committed because of manipulation through hypnosis. Now, the Texas Rangers have been using hypnosis on witnesses for 25 years. Did you know that? The Texas Rangers are using hypnosis. It's a wonderful investigative tool. 15 minutes of being in hypnosis, about 5 hours of a natural sleep. And it's a state of focused concentration.